We are over 6 months into Black Ops 4 now, and I can wholeheartedly say that the Blackout Battle Royale mode is hands down my favorite mode in the game as of right now. I find myself jumping on to grind out some wins on a near daily basis, and since I have completed most of the main objectives over in multiplayer, I do primarily flock to Blackout for a fresh gameplay experience. And with pretty significant changes coming to the mode on a relatively consistent basis, Blackout is constantly adapting and evolving. And today, I figured we'd sit down and take a look at 6 Blackout updates that could potentially change everything. What's up guys, Zachary Immortal here, welcome back to the channel, and thanks for stopping by. If you are new here, each and every single day, we are always covering the latest Black Ops 4 and Call of Duty news and information, so if you want to stay up to date with all of that kind of stuff, feel free to subscribe with your post notifications turned on, that way you'll always know when a new video goes live. And of course, if you enjoyed this video, let me know by dropping a like rating on it, as it would be much appreciated. And now, let's get into some huge updates that could completely change Blackout here in Black Ops 4. For starters, I do want to preface everything today by saying that what we are going to talk about over the course of the next few minutes is by no means confirmed as coming to the game. Instead, these are simply theoried updates that would have a pretty significant impact on Blackout's gameplay, and honestly, all these updates that we'll get into today, I do feel like have a pretty decent chance at eventually making their way into the game. But I digress. The first major update that would seriously change the way that Blackout flows, feels, and looks is a night mode or a nightfall map. Of course, the lighting in Blackout has changed a handful of times since launch, as when Blackout first went live, it was a nice bright sunny day. Then slowly, over the course of time, the sun began to sink lower and lower into the sky, eventually creating the spring lighting aesthetic that we have now, where the sun is setting and the entire map has fallen under a dusk lighting scheme, which honestly I think looks really, really good. Now obviously, if we are realistically breaking down the lighting changes that have happened on the Blackout map, presumably we are headed for nightfall, and originally when Operation Grand Heist first went live, prior to the spring map update even going live, we got a teaser for Alcatraz, in which we saw players dropping into Blackout under a darkened sky, and immediately everyone, myself included here, jumped to the conclusion that we were going to be getting a nightfall map or a night mode in Blackout. Obviously though, that did not happen, and instead, we got Alcatraz Portals, a quads mode that takes place on the Alcatraz Island where the sun definitely is not out, but it also doesn't necessarily feel like it's night either, as most of the areas on the map are still pretty well lit. Anyways, focusing back on the regular map, if we were to see an eventual nightfall mode or night version of the map, things would obviously be very, very different. Right off the bat, ranged engagements would be heavily altered since, presumably on a nightfall map, visibility, especially long-range visibility, would be limited quite a bit. On top of that, campers would probably wreak havoc on a nightfall map just by hiding in dark corners or proning in a bush, becoming completely invisible in most scenarios. However, this nightfall map or night mode, combined with a few other new updates that we'll be bringing up later on in this video, could actually be a really, really cool and fun way to play Blackout. A second huge update that could also seriously change up Blackout, for better or for worse depending on how you feel about the situation, is a weather variant map, or if we want to get really spicy, weather variant maps, as in plural or multiple. Of course, this is a pretty popular thing over in multiplayer, as we have seen Arsenal Sandstorm introduced, drastically changing how Arsenal plays, and we've also seen Contraband Hurricane, and outside of strictly weather variant maps, we've also seen lighting changes occur on Firing Range Night, Seaside Sunset, and soon-to-be Hacienda Twilight. So, the lighting aesthetic updates of Blackout have transitioned over to multiplayer. What's not to say the weather variants of multiplayer don't transition over to Blackout? My immediate go-to for a weather map update for Blackout would probably be some rainy or stormy map, but seeing as the map is currently already flooded with water, I think that might be a little bit overkill on the H2O for the time being, but perhaps in the future we could see a thunderstorm map where maybe lightning and thunder signify zone changes and rain makes it a little bit harder to control vehicles as you're driving across the map or something of that nature. Regardless, one can only assume we will eventually stray away from simple lighting changes in the future because, I mean, let's be honest, there's only so many lighting schemes you can have before you've ended up using them all, and maybe then weather variants will finally come into play on the Blackout map. The third update that I think would seriously change up Blackout is the implementation of destructible environments. Now, right off the bat, this is something that does not sound standard in a Call of Duty title. Of course, aside from Call of Duty Ghosts, which did it a little bit, but even then it was still very, very limited. Still though, the idea alone of having destructible environments in play could really change the dynamic when it comes to utilizing certain cover spots or even hiding in certain buildings. For this though, realistically, I don't think we could ever see a full-blown destructible map in which literally everything is able to be destroyed, but at the very least we could perhaps have destructible walls or basic buildings that we could use C4 or something to blast through, similar to how Spectre did in the Spectre Rising reveal trailer at Hydro Dam. Out of all of the updates I will bring up in this video though, I will admit this one is probably the most outlandish, but I would not count it out entirely. The next update I've got here is actually something that I see requested all the time, whether it be over on Twitter or in a stream or even in my own comments section, and that is a solo mode for Alcatraz. Now personally, I much prefer to play duos or quads in Blackout, as solo is just a little bit too campy for my liking, and honestly, playing with friends just enhances the experience a ton in my own opinion. But regardless, on Alcatraz in specific, a solo mode could be very, very interesting to see. Of course, questions would then be raised about the idea of redeploy, and maybe even upping the player count to 50 or so, just to increase the chaos a little bit. Hypothetically, I mean, we could have a solo Alcatraz mode where there's 50 or 55 players dropping in with, say, 3 lives each or something along those lines, and then the game plays out how it would per usual, just without the team dynamic. Obviously, this would be a huge change to the flow and pace of Alcatraz in general, and definitely would be an update that would be incredibly impactful. Continuing on, update number 5 that would seriously change things up for the Blackout mode is the addition of some new equipment in the form of perhaps Recon's Vision Pulse or Vision Goggles, and or a Thermal Scope. Now, obviously, these items are currently exclusive to the multiplayer mode. However, as I mentioned earlier, with the possibility of a Nightfall map on the horizon, something like a Thermal Scope could become incredibly, incredibly beneficial for all types of engagements. Of course, while your regular vision might be severely limited by the darkness of a Nightfall mode, using a Thermal Scope would allow you to potentially gain a much-needed advantage in those longer-range gunfights, and close-range, it could also be used to combat those corner campers. Also, night mode or not, vision goggles that allow maybe 3 or so uses to scan through a wall could be a cool twist to using, say, the sensor dart, which as of now is a pretty vital piece of equipment when it comes down to those late game engagements. And in a night mode, for instance, a sensor dart would undoubtedly be one of the hottest commodities available, so perhaps Recon's vision goggles could add some extra variety to the equipment department in that scenario. Finally, update number 6 that could really change Blackout, once again for the better or for the worse depending on your stance on the topic, is the addition of a Coward's Way Out option within our respawn modes, such as Alcatraz, Down But Not Out, and Hot Pursuit. A Coward's Way Out option to essentially immediately bleed out by choice when downed is actually something that David Vondahar brought up prior to Operation Spectre Rising ever going live. And admittedly, I thought it was going to be one of the new changes added into the new and improved Alcatraz map, but alas, no such option was added in. So, a Coward's Way Out update is still on deck and waiting to be released. But when it comes down to the pace and flow of the game, on Alcatraz especially, a Coward's Way Out option would likely make the game flow even faster and create much more chaotic scenarios, as downed enemies could effectively pick and choose when they wanted to drop back in on their opponents and go for revenge. Now, this one is definitely a more controversial update, as I've personally seen a lot of back and forth on the topic, even in the comments of some of my more recent videos. But nonetheless, it would certainly be a very impactful update that would have some serious effects on Blackout's gameplay. And there you guys have it. Those are 6 Blackout updates that could seriously change everything here in Black Ops 4. Out of all of these various updates that we covered here today, are there any in specific that you would love to see added to the game, or is there something else that you think should be added in? Definitely let me know down in the comments below. With that said, that does effectively wrap things up for today. If you guys enjoyed the video, let me know by dropping a like rating on it, as it would be much appreciated. And of course, if you are brand new here to the channel and you like what you see, feel free to hit that sub button and turn on your post notifications. That way you'll always know when a new video goes live. Once again, thank you guys so much for tuning in. And until next time, take it easy, have an awesome rest of your day, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.